Okay. So back where we killed the dog-like knight fort. And look at this. Holy shit. The camera even moved back. Wow. So that's definitely not where I was. Are there any items here? No. Okay. So let's I wanna look at this. Look at that. So there's a bridge leading to it, but it has been destroyed. Pretty much like in Bloodborne. And then over there is some kind of giant cathedral again, for lack of a better word. There's a lot of walls. So yeah, let's head to that undead settlement. Raise the banner! I don't know where I got that stick from. Da 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 da! Oh. Okay. Seriously? Okay. That's a blast from the past. Those are the same guys that in Dark Souls 1 bring you from Sans Fortress to Anor Londo. But now they bring you down instead of up. Thanks, guys. You look terrifying as ever. Okay, undead settlement. Let's light the bonfire. And rest at it. There we go. Let's see what all this is about. It looks amazing. What the hell is that? There's a giant on top of that building. Is he killing birds? Poor birds. Okay. So we can go down or left. I think left is probably not the way. Nope. There is an item here. Large soul of a deserted corpse. Nothing spectacular. So let's head down the stairs. A lot of undead praying at the gate this time. Anything else here? Doesn't look like it. Oh god. Wow. And now what? Okay, that one saw me. There we go. One doggy. Charge! This thing has a kick. Oh, wow. But this thing has a kick, wow. Alluring skull, okay, that's the item that lures enemies towards it. But nevertheless, I'll check it out. Skull resplendent in the scent of souls, prepared by evangelists at the Cathedral of the Deep. Throw to shatter, spreading souls which attract enemies, not effective for all foes. Apparently, it is effective for dogs. So a lot more of these praying... well, how should we call it? Turtle dudes? Try jumping. Yeah, sure. Oh, wow. There's another dead dragon over here. There's an item over there. Homeward bones. Two.
Please, grant me death. Undo my shackles.
Oh my god, there's one alive. Can we talk to you?
Oh, then it's true. A champion of Ash, as I live and breathe. To be in your presence is a great honor. I am Yol of Londor, a pilgrim, as you can see, only somehow I failed to die as was ordained. Well, perhaps my calling lies elsewhere. Say, champion of Ash, how does the idea of taking me into your service strike you? I was once a sorcerer. Surely I can be of use.
Yeah, definitely. Accept the service.
I am honored, truly. I should be dead, yet you have granted me purpose anew.
So Wormface is going to help me.
I do solemnly swear myself to you.
And he vanished as well. These guys are magicians. Good fellow ahead. Friend ahead. Yes, indeed. And that's another NPC. The gate closed again. Was I not fast enough? Bonfire ahead. Already? That guy looks not friendly. Let's open this thing. That dark damage is a bit creepy. Might have been because of the crows too. And another bonfire again. Okay then. Why? There's nothing... Okay. I'm gonna have to remember that guy, because at one point he's probably going to shoot me. What's this? Touch summon sign. Why is it purple? Okay, let's rest. Or light it. And then rest. I don't have enough for another level, so I'm gonna push on first. Again, corpses hanging from pretty much everything. Oh, hi. More undead dudes. What is that noise? Oh yeah, the guy at the door here. Okay, those guys can go die. And then what? Ooh. Did that guy just turn into a tree completely? There are a lot of weird noises in this place. Small leather shield. It features a large central protrusion designed for parrying attacks. only 42 physical defense. Didn't check the soldier's shield. It is never unwise to wear a sturdy form of head protection against arrows and other somatic threats. Oh, I can't see. Shit. Another one of those tree guys. Oh, there we go. He's wearing the same hat as that thief guy. Forgot his name. Charcoal Pine Bundle. Probably to add fire to my weapon. Does not last for long, but can be used in inventive ways, such as applying it in the middle of a series of blows. Okay, then why would that be handy? Okay! There's a big guy in the middle there. Worker hat. Maybe that can tell us a bit more about what's going on here. Hat worn by the inhabitants of the undead settlement. Official attire for the dissection and burial of the undead. Naturally, the ceremonial significance of such work is long forgotten. Indeed, no one could continue to entertain such horrors. So there's one guy in a robe in the middle. I'm gonna drop this thing for later use. Repair powder, with which I can repair my weapon, obviously. But now, is there a staircase over here? Yeah. It is pretty dark. I'm going up. Oh wow! Those little buggers are fast! Gloves. So I went downstairs and then it came from behind. There we go. And then those two down here. I can't see it. Wait, did it die? That's that one. Now the one with the arrows. There we go. Another charcoal pine bundle. Probably indicating that I should use my fireball. Nope, not yet. Okay, so now let's head towards this big open area. Are they gonna take a fence with me? one on the left. Oh, fuck. Oh, wow. Come to me. And that sounded female, creepily enough. So they are friendly enough to come at me one at a time. They do drop quite a bit of souls. Ooh, that was risky. Seems to be an issue with this thing. The second blow, it has so much knockback that it doesn't allow for a second blow. No mercy for the praying dudes. Yeah, there we go. I knew it. I fucking knew it. But I do love my shield. Okay. So area pretty much cleared. Soul of an unknown traveler. That looks like it hurt. So again, a few ways we can go. We can go down here, we can go across this bridge, which looks like I might do that first. Just check that giant archer and he doesn't shoot me in the back. Can't get down there, right? Don't put myself in a position where I can't return. Yeah, I can. Oh, hi! Bang! Four-pronged plow? I think that was. Yeah. This four-pronged plow is shaped like a fist and is a worker's tool in the Undead Settlement. Not originally intended for battle, but serves as a deadly weapon owing to its sharp points. It does kind of look like a hand. Oh, there's a lot of places to go. So we can go inside here. Is that a door we can talk to? No, but we can open it. And it's pitch black again. There's a hole. Oh, whoa, 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 okay, that scared the bejesus out of me. Charcoal pine resin. Hole required ahead. Treasure ahead. Die! So we can drop down there. Soup ahead. So that's a real one. Oh, come on, I hit first. Paranoia. Nope, you don't. Red eyes or not. So people are telling me there's soup downstairs. Might have to enter through the roof to get me some soup. So let's try that then. I'm gonna probably end up straight into the soup pot. Okay. Soup. Drink Estus soup. Oh no, he was fighting something. Warrior of Sunlight. Oh my god, is that what I think it is? Wait, what? What is that? Oh, hell yeah. That's from Solaire from Dark Souls 1. The Warrior of Sunlight, an ancient talisman depicting a holy symbol bestowed upon the Warriors of Sunlight, equipped to pledge oneself to the Warrior of Sunlight Covenant. Warriors of Sunlight are brilliantly beaming cooperators who place their golden signatures to help those in need, for it is their duty to deliver a great conquest to their summoner. So, hell yeah. Sun Bros. But now, Estus Soup. So that just heals me? Okay. Open the door. So this isn't one. Holy shit. Holy shit balls. Where the hell did they come from? I was prepared. And that's another real one, probably. And that too. There we go. Fading Soul. I haven't found any illusory walls yet. Okay then. Soul of an unknown traveler. The rays of sunlight going in do look a bit weird from this angle. There's another magic dude upstairs. So I'm gonna ignore that guy for now and let's check. I don't want to check all the other sides, but hey, let's continue. I'm gonna use my Ashen Flask since my bar doesn't go much further anyway. I don't want to. Those things don't come inside, I hope. Oh, yeah, why did I? Yeah, never mind. Oh! So that guy is upstairs.
Oh, come to me.
I'm confused. Okay! You, lady, are a bitch! Loretta's bone. This is really dangerous, but Loretta, isn't that the name we need to do, bring that ring to? Old discolored human bone with several holes bored into it. A woman's corpse in the undead settlement was found clutching this bone. Her name was Loretta. Okay. Could have been better. Hey, what's this? I'm gonna start buying healing miracles, I think. So last time I went inside. Okay then, so let's check this side then. Not with that net shard. So is this where they drop down from? These two little guys? Yeah. Holy shit! He almost killed me. Those guys are insane! So dropping down here would be a bad idea, I think. And I'm already out of Estus. But I do want my souls back. So let's see what else there is. So this is a dead end. This is empty except for that thing, so I can drop down here into the soup place. What happens now? It doesn't refill. Couldn't really refill my Estus with that. Okay, I thought that was a backstab. It wasn't. It wasn't. There we go. Cleaned out again. Thank you. Okay. Let's go underneath here again. So now she can't hit me. Well, I'm assuming it's a she. Sounds like a she, doesn't look like a she. I do want my souls back. Oh, did she drop down? I have a lot of souls. I don't wanna leave those souls. But I might lose them if I continue this way. Yeah, I'll stop singing right now. Sorry. So, this place. What's down here? Another titanite shard. Another place I don't want to drop down. Okay. So we can get on this roof as well. Oh, and there's a crystal lizard. Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna get that. Rusted coins. Yeah. Goodbye. What else do we have here? Because this keeps going. There seems to be something at the base here that might loop back to where I started. Bonfire! Never mind, bonfire. So I'm gonna head back to Firelink Shrine to level up. We have Undead Settlement, Dilapidated Bridge, and Foot of the High Wall. Final track. So let's level up. Very well taken. And now we'll head straight into Dexterity again. I can do two. Could get my dexterity up to 16. Maybe I'll forget about my vigor soon. Farewell, me. Oh wait, do you have anything else to say actually? Ashen since we killed that one? Be on kids. No. Ashen. Oh, he's back. Hello, guy.
Yet to give in, eh? Good. The firekeeper must be twitching with delight. But what do you really know about these Lords of Cinder? These supposed legends?
Not much.
Let's take Aldrich for one. A right and proper cleric. Only he developed a habit of devouring men. He ate so many that he bloated like a drowned pig. Then softened into sludge. So they stuck him in the Cathedral of the Deep. And they made him a Lord of Cinder, not for virtue, but for might. Such as a lord, I suppose. But here I ask, do we have a sodding chance?
I hope so. So, that was interesting. So that saint ate people and therefore turn into that black sludge monster we saw in the beginning.
At the foot of Lothric Castle, an old path still runs below the tower in the Undead Settlement. It was used to transport sacrifices to the Cathedral of the Deep. You should see where it leads.
Yeah, I should.
If you've the stones for it.
Was that a hint? Do we need stones for something?
At the foot of Loth, it was...
Okay, that's the same. Weapon check. What can we use? We can use the Uchi Katana, which is actually really interesting. Although it does a lot less damage than the Astora Straight Sword. Troll Axe. Ultric Slaves. A cunning weapon for a cunning lot. This axe is quick and deadly. Okay then. And the rest we've seen, I think. Let's try the Uchi Katana. Vertical slashes and a thrust, which is very interesting on its own. And so when we hold it, we can slash or we can do a parrying blow. Interesting. Might try this a bit. How good is it scaling D already? So they might go up even further. Well, I'm doubting whether I should add poison fire to this. Maybe I should add it to the straight sword. So let's try and transform our straight sword into a fire Astora straight sword.
Ah, tis quite neat.
So infuse the Astora straight sword with fire. So we need a bit more gems. Souls. So let's use a few. That should be enough. So infuse the Astora straight sword with refined. What is refined? It seems to just boost. It lowers the base damage, but it boosts the attribute bonuses. But fire damage. Awesome. I want to see what the refined Uchi Katana turns the strength scaling to a D immediately.
Immediately.
Okay, be careful.
So let's take that Astora fire sword. And maybe can I just improve my Uchi Katana? I can't even improve the fire sword. What do I need for that? Titanite shards. Oh, so fire just stays titanite shards. Yeah, let's boost the Uchi Katana. And let's switch between those a few times to see what works best. And let's return to where we were, to the dilapidated bridge. I think I'm gonna take a break, because I've been recording for quite a while now. I can hear that crystal lizard up top. So I hope you liked the video. If you did, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel at youtube.com/trophynutplays. That's trophynut with TROVNUT. And that really helps if you subscribe. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!